Hey, what's going on, bingers? Binge Pulse here, back again with another video. This one I'm going to be doing my review for the Netflix movie, The Willoughbys. So this movie is directed by three people, Chris Pern, Corey Evans, Rob Lottermere, and it stars Will Forte, Maya Rudolph, Elisa Cara, Ricky Gervais, and Terry Crews. Now, the Willoughbys are characters that were basically a higher upper scale class. We passed down from generation to generation, but what's interesting is these are just kind of the washed up generation. So the kids find a baby in a box, parents don't like it, throw them out of the house, and then the story ensues. So what I love about this animated movie is the animation's very clean. It's nothing too over the top. It's easy to watch. A lot of times I feel like a lot of animated movies are just too sloppy, thrown all over the place. A lot of times it's just overwhelming. Whereas this movie, you're going to get a very clean, straightforward animated movie. The colors are well crafted, yet smooth. So I got to say, Will Forte does an excellent job as the boy. You can feel that they're siblings. It's nothing that's too forced. A lot of the humor in this movie is rather slapstick. A lot of stuff in the background that's just kind of going on while the front of the point of view is from the kids doing, you know, kid stuff. My favorite performances in the film are from Maya Rudolph, who plays the nanny, Terry Crews as Commander Melanoff, and Ricky Gervais, who plays the cat. What's cool about this movie is how these side characters just blend in really well with these kids and how they put an impact on these kids more so than their parents actually do. Even though this movie's a fun time, unfortunately, I feel as if this movie didn't really know what it wanted to be. It suffered rather like an identity crisis in the film. I feel as if that's because we had three directors in the helm of this film. That unfortunately happens in a lot of movies. You have different visions going on, and it kind of shows in the movie. The problem is I can't tell if it's for kids or if it's for adults. There's a lot of adult humor in this film. The parents have a very intimate relationship in this film, and it comes off kind of cringy, actually. Yeah. There was not a sex scene in this movie, but there could have been. It is Netflix. Even though these actors do a good job playing these kids, unfortunately, I feel like with the writing, the kids really don't have too much of a uniqueness to them. I feel as if this movie's actually a very mediocre written screenplay. And unfortunately, I feel as if 10 years from now, nobody's going to remember this movie. It's going to be one of those kind of movies where you're just going to be scrolling long after, and kids are going to be like, what's this movie? The Willoughbys. Overall, if you're looking for a good animated movie to watch, this isn't for kids, I feel, that are under the age of 8. This is more of like that 8 to teenage years. I enjoyed it as an adult, but I feel as if this movie unfortunately suffers with its identity crisis, mediocre plot. If you're looking for a quick hour and a half movie to watch, go check this one out. I give The Willoughbys a 2.5 out of 5. And until next time, keep on binging.